I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that's shining always gonna be gold. I'll be fine once I get it.
I'm here with
Lydia.
I'm Anna.
Anna Hannah.
Grace Dion.
Adeline.
Jade.
Melanie.
Ruby.
And
Daniela.
I'm Rita.
Bianca.
Jesse.
Martina.
Teresa.
Chloe Thomas.
Lucy.
Lucy. The other one.
Emma Winter.
Kate.
Kayla.
Ashleen.
Julia.
And Yuko.
Caitlin McHale.
Rayhana.
Holly.
Laura Donaldson.
Hosanna.
Ash.
Abu.
Madeline.
Jaslyn.
Amy.
Serena Barros.
I mean.
Rana Muhammad.
The head girl.
Yep.
Kinesu.
Isabella.
Giselle.
Truly.
The ducks of the college.
Maxine!
I got a couple questions for you. What's your name?
Maxine.
And Maxine.
Yo, what's up? I'm here with Evelyn. What is your most embarrassing moment at St. Dominic's?
I would probably say maybe Mr. An caught me playing games on my computer during science, and he called me out in front of the whole class.
There's hydrogen and helium, then lithium.
I'm not embarrassing, so therefore I'm just too cool for that.
I think honestly just showing up every day. Oh, and my short hair.
Oh, yeah, I can't remember. Like, I just always forget.
I feel like I'm just... If I'm an embarrassing person, I just don't feel the embarrassment, you know? So I don't think I have anything to say. I don't know.
Probably when I was walking into school and I forgot to zip up the back of my skirt and I wasn't wearing shorts.
I ripped my skirt and someone told me that they had seen it the whole day and they didn't tell me.
In RE, I was sitting behind Amber and Amber threw popcorn at me and I got in trouble for it, even though Amber was the one that threw popcorn and I had to sit outside for the whole of the lesson.
I'm here with Amber. And we're just going to ask her a couple questions. What is your most embarrassing moment at St. Dom's?
Probably when I kissed Bronson.
I knocked some girl's slushie over and I ran away.
I think I went into the bathroom and then I got locked into it because one of the teachers locked me in.
The most embarrassing story would be have to be driving my cousin's car to school.
Can't think. I didn't say that in front of the class. It was on a piece of paper. You were one of 10 names. I'm quite perfect, to be honest.
Kidding.
On multiple occasions, I've peed my pants in the classroom.
Year 9.
The whole of year 9?
I had to MC and I kind of fobbed out, but I don't think anyone noticed, but I did.
One time I was in the chapel and I farted really loudly and it was really quiet and everyone heard it. And there was like parents there as well. It was really embarrassing.
I don't even remember it. Like, so what happened?
Honest. Everyone said ooh, and apparently I was eating a sandwich and got really self-conscious, so...
Probably when I fell asleep on the bus and the bus driver had to honk the horn for me to get off.
I have to say, in year 7 when I was saying my speech and then I forgot to flip my cue cards and I lost where I was and I ran out of the class crying.
That time that I came here and had full attendance. I'm kidding, of course. That time that I came here and had 60% attendance. My usual was 40.
With Anna. I regret that decision so much.
Anna, what do you have to say about this?
I'm actually crying right now.
Probably when I went to careers and I stayed in the wrong class for 30 minutes.
Probably all the outfits I wore on Mufti Days in year 7.
Probably being friends with Ying Ying.
Ooh. And
being interviewed right now.
And
all year 7 when I had that backpack and I walked like.
Okay, so you see those stairs over there?
Yes.
Yeah? So in year 7, I had a really heavy backpack and I was walking up those stairs and I fell over and I couldn't get up because of my backpack, so I crawled.
Oh!
lot of people watching me as well, so yeah.
One time, my friend ate a banana.
And she lifted on the ground. I didn't notice and I sat on it. And then everyone started laughing and I started crying.
And when I was on Duke of Ed and there was a pickle.
And I thought it was one of my friends, like, you know, eat this burger and there's like a pickle. And I'm like, oh, you don't like the pickles. And I ate it. And it was no one from our school's pickles, like some random.
Yeah.
Probably when I cried in the pool during PE.
When I used to do my meetups behind the gym in year 11.
Yes.
Probably when I ran out of stats class crying because of the sky.
But I used to go to the front gate just so listen guys will notice me.
And I had my 14th birthday and I cried so much that Miss Arkin sent me home.
Probably when me and my friend group filmed like a private schoolgirl parody.
Before yesterday when I went into academic assembly when I wasn't supposed to be there. And I had to walk out.
Probably falling off my chair in digital.
Assembly, there was like slippery stairs and I slipped on my face. Everyone looked at me and I just cried.
I tripped in front of the entire school one time. That was kind of embarrassing.
Oh no.
Mine would be Commando rolling down a flight of stairs.
Mommy raised a princess, but Daddy raised a savage.
Amy should wear a mask because she's like a disgrace to all human race and she's just worthless.
Yo, my best friend till the very end. Cause best friends don't have to pretend. You need a hand and I'm right there, right beside you. You in the dark, I'll be the bright light to guide you. Remember the time, sticking out the house. All of the times that you had your doubts. And don't forget all the trouble we got into. We got something you can undo, do. Laughing so damn hard, crashed your day. Drive you crazy. Sometimes I know I call you lazy.
I need to go catch the bus. Bye!
What is some advice you have for the younger years?
Am I allowed to swear?
Yeah.
Is this going anywhere?
No.
Just don't give a f.
Cool.
Just YOLO. Live life.
Just live life in the moment. Like, don't keep overthinking the future. Just live in the present.
It doesn't matter.
Don't procrastinate.
Procrastination is key. You'll still get it done. You might as well have fun.
And also, like, in year 7, 8, 9, and 10, don't be stressed because literally it doesn't matter.
Stay in school and just enjoy life with your friends.
Take NCEA level 2 seriously or else you won't get into a good program in uni. Yeah.
There's no point trying, you'll get in where you want anyway.
Have fun and stay out of drama.
Try to come to school every day, at least for a period.
Make sure your handwriting's actually readable.
Study period in year 13.
Have fun. Don't listen to the rules. Okay.
Drop out and become a stripper.
To be honest, don't stress. It's literally not that big of a deal and you're probably going to forget it. Like, within the next year.
Have fun. Oh, it's not so serious. It's nothing's that serious.
Don't fret about the little things.
Don't worry as much. And also, you know, just don't be embarrassed.
Don't take everything so seriously. No one's going to ask you when you leave what you got. And yeah, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and NCA, so take it easy.
It's really not that serious, and don't stress out about your grades, I guess.
Don't stress, don't overthink everything, live it up, you know, make friends.
You don't have to get excellence, it's the same credits, just get achieved.
Wag every day.
Honestly, school goes very fast, so enjoy every moment and take every opportunity and...
Freaking leave. Like, I was meant to move to Mags and I wish I did.
Don't come the doms.
Leave the school right now.
Don't come St. Dominic's.
I hope you all stay in school. Don't do drugs unless they're given to you for free.
Don't let Jew dates pressure you. Pressure the Jew date so that it won't exist anymore.
Sleep now or you'll never sleep. Be able to sleep ever again.
Make the use of your teachers. They're there to help you. So, you know, talk to them, ask them questions, get feedback. Yeah. And don't be scared of the year 13s.
Get your driver's license. I still don't have that and it's not good.
Do as much as possible every day.
I think just have a positive outlook on life, because no matter how hard it is or how difficult a situation is, there will always be something positive that comes out of it in the longer run.
Don't vape in the gym toilets. You'll get caught.
Don't vape in groups, guys. Not worth it.
Get all your friends' study classes to wag.
Just stop vaping. It's going to ruin your future. Yeah.
Just be nice to everyone. Don't be a bitch. Don't bully.
No comment.
Live your life.
Participate and do your schoolwork.
I was in the 212. I'm the uptown A, nigga. You know what's up or don't you? Worker who made ya? I'm a rude bitch, nigga. What are you made up of? I'ma eat your food up, boo. I could bust your eight. I'ma do one too. Fuck it, gun do. When you do make bucks, I'ma look right, nigga. Bet you do want to. Fuck. Fuck them like you do want to. Come, you gated, get discovered. I'm a 2-1 deuce. Cock a licking in the water by the blue bayou. Caught the warm goose. And you do rag too, son. Nigga, you're a Kool-Aid dude. Plus your bitch might lick it. Wonder who let you come to 1-2. What you do to crew, son? Fuck are you into, huh? Niggas better ooh run run. You could get shot, homie, if you do want to. Put your guns up. Tell your crew don't front. I'm a hoodlum, nigga. You know you were too.
And where do you see yourself in 5 years' time?
I see myself marrying a rich man and getting the big bucks.
The big bucks.
That's what matters to me, the big bucks.
I want to be rich.
If I'm really successful and rich.
With a lot of money.
Rich, big titties, big ass, good body.
Rich and have lots of money.
Low-key rich, maybe driving a Porsche.
I want a Tesla.
I've married or found some rich guy.
Rich and famous.
On a yacht with a sugar daddy.
I'm rich as fuck.
Oh, am I?
I don't think I'm making it that far.
Editor of Vogue.
Be a dentist though? Leaving Otago?
Being a fashion designer or designing for a business.
In the animation industry.
Hopefully a lawyer. Helping people.
Probably poor. Doing a crappy law internship.
Well, I hope I'm doing well. I hope I'm in Australia living my best life as a midwife.
I hope I finish school and don't drop out in uni. Please, Jane.
Move schools.
5 years from now.
Oh, 5 years from now?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I'm running from backwards.
Take a break.
Nah, 23 is young to be engaged. Probably still flying, probably traveling, and hopefully not pregnant.
I'm hopefully pregnant with the husband, maybe.
Mom.
Probably pregnant.
Yeah.
I hope I still have no kids in 5 years, because I don't want kids in 10 years or so. So, yeah.
Definitely on the beach.
Probably buried in a pink coffin.
We're gonna meet up in the UK.
Oh, probably.
Just go back to Japan.
Cool.
No, I will come back.
Single.
And ready to mingle.
Hopefully a dentist, living it up, maybe in Europe or something, like married to like a guy from the Netherlands. That's like really tall.
Yeah.
I expect myself to either be A, dead, or B, living my life in New York City, Lily Chi lifestyle, so.
Some guy in, like, Paris or, like, America or something, I will go hunting and I will let you guys know what happened.
In London.
Hopefully with a uni degree of some sort and traveling if I can.
Traveling the world.
Hopefully rich, hopefully in New York City, hopefully thriving, living, everything.
Probably still at uni or in England.
Probably still be in uni doing some long course, or hopefully maybe graduate it from a shorter course and just living my life.
I don't really know what I'm going to be doing tomorrow, so I don't know how I'm supposed to figure out what I'm going to do in 5 years. So.
Alive and happy.
A wag, or I don't know, living it up in like London as a successful woman. Cut that, I don't know.
Happy, healthy, 30, flirty, and thriving.
Hopefully underground.
Stripping for money. Oh, broke, homeless.
Oosh.
Happiness hit her like a train on a track. Coming towards her. Very, very much.
chances on my